In this video, I'm going to be mastering Valorant in the space of just 1 week. That's right, 7 days. I'll be using a complete course in AimLab dedicated to improving your aim in Valorant, as well as using all the different practice modes in Valorant to see how good they really are. I've mastered Rainbow Six Siege in 1 week, but can I do the same with Valorant? Watch the entire video to find out. Be sure to subscribe too. But with that, let's begin. I was at the time essentially a very casual player of Valorant. Played it since the beta and played it very on and off. Now, throughout this, there are 4 drills that I'm going to be targeting and running throughout every single day. First off, on AimLab, after I converted my sensitivity and crosshair to suit the settings, we were ready to go. I was going to complete this combine course that they had set up every single day and see how my score would improve. This course was essentially packed with every single drill you could use in Valorant and need for in-game situations. And there was also one where you had to track your enemies, and this wasn't cool or practice or fun. This was painful, and it hurt my hand, and every time it turned red and I wasn't tracking it, it was mocking me. Continuing on, in Valorant I was going to be using 3 of the different practice modes available to me. First off, I'll be doing 10 minutes of defuse the spike, and then I'll be doing 10 minutes of planting the spike, and the difficulty was set to hard. And these are in-game situations designed to make you throw your keyboard across the room and break your monitor, as they have the reaction time of someone like Tens. Sorry, the reaction time of Tens if you just ate 10 scoops of raw G Fuel. Then I'd also be doing 10 minutes of the practice mode in which I'd go through different aiming situations, what I was struggling with, and work on that. And before I got into these drills, I had to make sure I could identify my weaknesses. And, well, I found them pretty quickly. Turns out I was awful at everything. And, well, aiming was a problem, recoil control a problem, crosshair placement a problem, so we had a lot of work to cover. In total, it worked out to about 45 minutes of practice every single day, on top of that, games of Valorant that I would be playing afterwards to see how my improvement happened in-game. And oh boy, we definitely improved in the end. Day 1. The very first day started off with a lot of nerves and, quite frankly, I didn't know how to peek any single corner. On the spike defuse mode, I only got 4 wins, and on the spike plant mode, I got an even scarcer 2 wins. Which essentially means I only managed to clear out all the bots and plant the spike at once every 5 minutes. Which equates to, yeah, 2 wins in 10 minutes. Looking back on it now, my mechanics are, well, completely different. I didn't really know the positioning of where the bots would spawn, I wasn't really confident, and quite frankly, my peeking techniques, my recoil control, and how I was using the Vandal in those situations was completely off. But luckily, we still had the AimLab practice to redeem ourselves. For the very first task, I started off with some default flicking onto different targets at the same time with the Ghost, the pistol that you use in Valorant and the Eco round. And my pistol aim was definitely my weak point because I didn't realise that I needed to hit my headshots, and quite frankly, I couldn't do that. Then it moved on to a reaction time test, which I actually thought was a flicking test at the time. Instead of clicking when the red target appeared, I flicked onto it and aimed at the target. So when on Twitter I saw a pro player using it and not even flicking onto the target, I thought to myself, wow, this guy's good. I can't even see him flicking onto the actual target and aiming on it because he's that fast. Turns out you didn't need to hit the target, you just had to click anywhere on the screen when the red target appears. And I only found this out on day 3. Even though I was doing it wrong, I still had a really good score here and my reaction time was on point. Surprisingly, I hit a pretty respectable score here for my very first day. The next task was the tracking task, which made me want to uninstall Valorant and AimLab at the same time. You had to painfully track individual targets and make sure your crosshair stayed on them. Then we moved on to my favourite task of the entire course. It was themed around the map Ascent, and you had to be in this little cubby area and peek onto the different side and take out the according targets that appeared on your screen. This is probably the core reason my pistol aim got a lot better. Final task of this combine course, the big bertha of them, was you making your way through a map on Haven onto the sea site, and the targets were dotted around everywhere. You had to take them out whilst they were dealing damage to you, making sure you could minimize it and get to the end. At first, this one was a struggle for me, but hey, at least I was doing it right, unlike the reaction time one. We've all had that moment where we swing the corner and the whole enemy team's been there, but well, when there's more than 5 of them, that's a bit hard, isn't it? Well, that's exactly what this task faced. I had no clue where they were positioned, and when I swung a corner, there was about 6 or 7 of them on one What's position firing at me. So now I had completed my very first day, and my score for the combine course was 54,000. My speed was 1.3 seconds, my accuracy was 71.2%, my reaction time was 0.29 seconds, and well, my tracking was, 32%. It's safe to say we can definitely improve with that one. So what happened after day one? From there on out, I stayed consistent with the practicing, dedicating 45 minutes every single day. On day two, I saw an immediate improvement in the spike diffuse and spike plan, roughly because I knew the locations of the bots and what I was looking out for on the map knowledge. Day two hits 10 wins on spike diffuse and 5 wins on the spike plant. I definitely found planting the spike a lot harder than actually diffusing it, hence why I got more wins the majority of the time. We saw a very subtle improvement on day two for Aim Lab. We hit 55,000, which is an improvement, but it is quite a small one too. On day three, I hit 11 wins on spike diffuse and 5 on spike plant, so a minor improvement here again. On the flip side, on day three in Aim Lab, we saw a bigger improvement than we did on the previous day. We hit 57,000 4-hour score, and that is already an improvement of around about 3,000. By this day, my hand actually started to hurt when I was playing, so I had to look up some stretches, and once I found that, it slowly started to go away. But you know what they say, right? No pain, no gain. And we were about to get these sweet, sweet radiant gains for sure. On day four, I definitely felt my crosshair placement start to improve a significant amount. In the practice mode, my flicking was a lot more clean, and the main thing I was going for here was trying to get my flicking and reaction time just to be able to flick onto an enemy from the left side or the right side and hit them with that one-tap headshot. On day four, hit 11 wins on spike diffuse and 7 on the spike plant. On day four, we hit 63,000, already a 6,000 improvement from the previous day, in total a 9,000 score improvement from day one. By now, I was definitely starting to feel the results kicking in, and it gets even more insane as we go on. Day five saw a 66,000 score improvement, which is what we hit, and we were already seeing that linear improvement, which is very, very nice to see. By now, I was really feeling confident in terms of my crosshair placement and how I was flicking onto the enemy. Day 6 hit 14 wins in spike diffuse and 10 on the spike plant, which is insane when you compare it to what I had before. I had 2 and 4. And we hit 68,000 in the score, and every single day that we've done so far, it's gone up, which was crazy to me to see. Now, the final day, day 7. Before I show you the comparison, the results, the score from day 1 and day 7, take a look at my aim on day 1, take a look at my aim on day 7. Day one looked like this. Oh. And on day seven, here's what my aim looked like. The improvement to me was crazy. And on day seven, we peaked at 72,000 on the score. And day one looked like 54,000, which means we've gone up by around about 18,000 over the entire week. My aim improved massively, and I started focusing on my recoil control too. I was confident and I was ready and raring to play. You can see it in the gameplay, and you can see it in the results. If you haven't joined the Discord, there's a link down below to do so, and right now on your screen is another video showing you how I mastered a different game in just 1 week too. Click on it, and be sure to subscribe and drop a like if you did enjoy the video.